is Janine, representing for His Imperial Majesty and Empress Menin, and Boom Shots, Rastafari love.
Watch out, Boom Shot. Y'all tell him to tell us a make the way to murmur now. So this one, I'm sure, shot to kill us. Boom Shot! Boom Shot.
So keep it green with the highest meditation and the proper steam. We advocating fire, burn it down. Coconut fire, no, we never the fall without it. Fire, light the way. Nasty little teacher boy touching on my nephew, stirring up the dragon in my head. Blood bubbling like a boy might.
Straight off the stage, that was a hot performance on a cold day.
Oh, yes. Give thanks, give thanks.
I love that you said rain is a blessing, because you know what, it's true. Like, there's a certain vibe you get from the rain, and I felt like you were giving off some vibes.
You really get to see who is the hardcore fans when they're standing in the rain to watch, you know, so I really appreciate all that.
So you've mentioned you've been here in London before, but how are you feeling apart from feeling like you're in the freezer right now?
I'm feeling good. The shows have been a great reception so far. Lots of love from London. Every time I come, there is more love, more people tuning into the music. So I definitely feel good about this trip.
Can I just say, like, I trekked it in the rain here, because I have to say the 9mm mixtape.
Like it.
How is that even a mixtape? It's got 80.
It's not a mixtape. It's not. It is groundings, you know. So I finished the record, and I wanted to put something out that I could give away right away, because I mean, otherwise I'd just go crazy waiting to let everybody hear. But I went into studio and produced, you know, put some tracks together, found some tracks that I really love, some dub instrumentals from Mad Professor, and dropped some heavy literature on it, you know. And then I did some remakes of some covers that I really like
Avocado,
right? Well, Avocado is my song, but I put it on a new groove, you know. And then I did some covers of like some really inspirational sisters, like, you know, Nina Simone and and Tracy Chapman. So just giving the people a little vibes of, you know, what to expect, you know, put them in the right frame of mind. So when the album drop, everybody's already ready to receive.
I'll be honest with you, when I was going through that mixtape, I was like, I mean, the works that went on into that must have, and the sizzler, I mean, 7 minutes long, we all timed it.
That was so much fun. Because like before I did it, I chose the songs I liked, my favorite sizzler. And then I did a little survey with all of my friends in WhatsApp, like, give me a top five sizzler. And then I took, you know, which one, you know.
But that's not an easy thing to do.
No. But you know, if you love it, it don't really feel like so much work, you know. So it was really, really fun to put together. So I did that in like 3 days.
Did he say anything?
I don't talk to him about it. You know, I don't need his permission.
No. But like, I just wondered if he had like
said. Such a great inspiration to so many of my generation. You know, he wrote the hymns that we grew up listening to that helped us on our journey. So it is a great honor to you know.
Respect that.
Yeah.
What of all the artists, like you said, of a new generation, he's incredible. His catalogue is incredible. But you did some justice on that.
Give thanks.
I gotta ask. I mean, since I've always like played with your name, like 999. Like, I get it. Is it 2 + 0 + 1 + 6 is 9?
It's the year of the 9. Yes, and it's not just because I say so. You know, like, it is a universal understanding that this is the year of 9. It is the year of a feminine rising. It is the year of completion and renewal, you know. Many powerful metaphysical happenings in this year. For those who, you know, have ears and eyes to perceive these things, they will be aware of it, you know. And so it was the most appropriate time to drop it. And September the 9th, so it's a perfect 9 across the board. And I couldn't have planned it if I tried. It just worked out that this is when, you know.
So you know it's the right time.
Yes, I.
Before we move away from that mixtape, I noticed you had a lot of like yoga, prana talk in there.
Right.
And anyone who does yoga knows I've done yoga on and off over the years, and that is a real, you know, people do it to lose weight or people do it for this or that, but really it's a
spare lifestyle. It is just like Rastafari is a liberty, you know. It's not religion. And a lot of people, especially people in the diaspora, you know, who have been indoctrinated by Judeo-Christianity, they, anything that Massa tell them is different and African and not of the West, they're going to take it as something that they should be afraid of. So a lot, when I just started doing yoga and teaching yoga, I mean, I had to break a lot of ground to get people to understand that this is not no devil thing. This is life. This is learning how to use your breath to heal yourself, to enliven your body, and how to live with your brothers and sisters. The same messages of Rastafari, the same liberty, you know, moving yourself closer toward the Most High, you know, through meditation and concentration and withdrawal from the outside world, you know. So positive things. So I had to find the right books that had those messages to help the brothers and sisters understand the importance of this.
Was that a self-taught thing for you?
Yoga, no, I actually trained. I trained in Iyengar, in the Iyengar method. I trained in Yin yoga as well. I trained in Kemetic yoga. So I am a student of this thing. I want to understand all the different schools, you know.
Have you been to India to...
Not yet. But you know, Africa is the home of yoga, you know. This is a controversial topic, but it's true. And you'll see the inscriptions on the wall that predate even Hatha yoga that say, yeah, man in a day. See Osar in his pose and they're standing, and all of these things are Kemetic poses, and the sesh pose and shu and the connection with the breath. All of this is Africa moving upward and bringing knowledge through the whole world, you know.
Amazing. And like, you also promote marijuana, which is becoming, everybody has, it's like starting to realize this is a herb that's helping people, and for years this message was suppressed.
True. And we know why. We know that is economics. You know that once big pharma and all the people who have money and, you know, don't like the idea that this thing is so easy to grow and the average man can get his hands on it. You don't really want people to be empowered that way. But the message is getting out there, you know. Chemotherapy is poison. We promote people not using this. People are dying because they are poisoning themselves. They're using these very invasive things and cutting into their bodies, and that is not the approach. People are more willing to cut out them organs than feed themselves properly, you know. People don't understand that a cure is a much more expensive thing than a prevention. You see me?
So, as somebody who's a yoga teacher who understands about breathing, who understands about lifestyle, you talk about your food and your lifestyle being so important, do you think that marijuana is something that goes parallel and hand in hand with that type of lifestyle?
I think herbs in general, herbs are our medicine. Marijuana is one of many medicines that Jah has given us, you know, that the universe has prepared for us. If you watch the animals, when they are ill, them go and them eat bush. Dogs don't eat, dogs are not vegetarians, but when they are ill, they know which bush to go and find. You have your Guinean weed, you have moringa, you have so many different things in nature that are there. People don't have to be sick, you know. Them just slaughtered Dr. Sebi a while ago, because he's spitting the truth. A whole lot of holistic practitioners of medicine went missing in the States. And this is all because they know that the cure is in the way you eat, you know? This is how you get things into your body. Pharmaceuticals are poison.
What do you think of the law that Jamaica passed in January for like starting to...
I think it is a positive step. I think it is a little short-sighted, and I think, you know, it wasn't so very well thought through. But any step in the right direction, we give thanks for it, because at least the youths won't be persecuted and, you know, given a criminal record for something that is quite, quite natural.
So before we go, I know we have to wrap up, but 9th of September... I mean, what more than this can we actually look forward to?
I am just really excited. This is my first release as Steam Chalice Records, my productions, you know. Me and the wheel, making sure that the music is exactly what I want. Working with some great producers who are my brethren, and, you know, they've given me the permission to take the rhythms and do as I please with them, and then I was able to create my own music around my words, and that's really what I've always wanted to do. So in the producer's chair, putting out this record as nine self-titled, ready for the world, and I just really am hoping that the people are as happy about it as I am.
Oh, I get the feeling they are.
Well, I am Parasilasi, what with the old time I say, yo, now you be give me could teach them how for pray. Show us the way, let us be sanctified. Fire blaze, I now cool nothing.